This week, Sean and I took a day trip to an amazing park overlooking the ocean. It's home to eagles and owls and all sorts of amazing wildlife. It's basically the Garden of Eden, and we found enough plants in there for about a dozen episodes, so stay tuned. One plant we found in crazy abundance was nipplewort. Never heard of it? You've probably seen it and never knew, since it grows everywhere. Nipplewort is a really hardy and delicious invasive weed that grows across North America, Europe, New Zealand, Chile, parts of North Africa, and South Africa. It has a slightly hairy spade-shaped leaf that grows in a rosette pattern. The flowers look like mini dandelions. They're between 10 and 20 millimeters in size, and they open only in the daylight. The flowers have no particular smell. When you pull off the leaves, you may notice that they leak a somewhat milky juice. This won't harm you, but it has a tendency to stain everything around it brown, so I do recommend wearing gloves while harvesting. Though there hasn't been extensive medicinal research published about nipplewort, it was at least eaten since the days of the Roman Empire and used for at least 350 years to ease the pain of cracked nipples from nursing, hence the name, as well as ingested to staunch the flow of milk upon weaning. One of the best things about nipplewort is that bugs don't seem to like it, so it's literally just waiting there for you until you harvest it. Some have confused nipplewort with sow thistle, but it doesn't have spiny leaves like sow thistle. We will cover sow thistle in another episode very soon. You can definitely eat nipplewort raw, in a salad, or on a sandwich. It is delicious, but a bit too bitter for some people, and it cooks up beautifully, so today we will cook with it. We're going to need a thawed loaf of white bread dough in a minute. Preheat the oven to 350 degrees. Put about a third cup of your favorite broth in a skillet and cook about 2 cups of your favorite veggies in it. We're not reinventing the wheel here. We just used whatever we had in the fridge because we didn't have time to go shopping before lunch. Anyway, cook up the green veggies for about, 3 to 5 minutes on medium-high heat and just before they're done. So we still want them a bit al dente. Take them out once they're done, remove them from the heat. Save a little bit of the juice left in the skillet because we're gonna add about 3 healthy handfuls of the nipplewort. Cooks way down, so 3 healthy handfuls seems like a lot, but it's not really. Remove it from the heat as soon as it looks done, and add about 1/2 cup of cheese in there. We just used whatever we had on hand, but I usually like to use 2% white cheese. I also put about 3 tablespoons of cottage cheese in there, which you can omit if you don't have or don't like it. And 1 for me.
What?
And also I put about 1 heaping tablespoon of cream cheese in there just because we had it and we didn't have any bagels. So what good is cream cheese without a bagel? Stir it all up until it's nicely combined. Roll the bread dough out to about 1/4 inch thick, or make your husband do it. Thanks, Sean. Once it looks evenly rolled, we're gonna dump the filling on there and spread it out evenly. Now what we want to do is seal it up. If you've added too much filling in there like I did, this may happen. Well, an easy way to fix this is to take some of that out. And don't worry, we'll hide that ugly seam. When you put it on the pan, just try to seal up as many holes as you can so that it is nice and smooth. You don't want anything leaking out when it bakes. I'm just smoothing it out. There we go. Beautiful. And so now we're gonna put it in the oven that we preheated. Great job. 35 minutes later. It's a miracle. There it is. so much better than I expected. A nice, hot loaf of bread filled with good stuff. Let it sit for about 5 minutes, and then try to probably serve it with some salad. We dropped the ball here, but I swear it was still so good. So I hope you've enjoyed this episode, and stay tuned for next week's episode, which I'm going to spoil for you now.
Delicious.
Wildflower champagne. Thanks for watching, and happy foraging.